morning, you guys. What is up? Turumba here. Welcome back to our Thea the Awakening, or better now, the Return of the Giants. We're gonna start that quest basically now. Din, 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 din. So, and the thing is, the enemies are gonna be way worse.
You come to a place that looks like a barren hillside, with one old tree stump sticking out like a sore thumb. You don't see anyone here, but you're sure this is the place you were meant to go. Suddenly, the hillside under the tree stump shakes, and a set of large green eyes opens up and looks at you.
Hello, strangers. You come here looking for knowledge, but I am old and sleepy. Why should I tell you anything about my own kind?
Two elves in your party speak up. You are the Oak Father, are you not? We remember stories of our wisdom. Surely you can aid us now. We're told you can help us save Thea from the new threat. You're old and wise, and surely you know the dangers of your kin's awakening. Both is not that bad, actually. Let's go with the elves. Maybe they have...
The forest children. Yes, you are correct. I am a giant, and your kin did once call me Oak Father. Alas, the oak is now a mere stump, and Stump Father does not ring so nicely. I have long ago pledged my loyalty to the little forest kin, and so I will help you. You want to know why my brothers and sisters now plague your homes, and I can tell you this.
Please tell us all you can.
The giants, as you call us, were indeed the builders of Thea. Called upon by ancient powers, we were tasked with keeping the destructive force of chaos in check. We hummed the song of life, and its melody ensured the world changed, but calmly, in time. Without our song, chaos would shift your lands and twist them out of existence. But in the days when the younger peoples, like yourselves, began to populate Thea, we became a danger. The Wild Wives and the Vjelkolud were gentle and calm, but not during our mating season. Our mating custom. Well, you can imagine, I am sure. And so, a council of elves, dwarven runemasters, and human goods, with my help, created the Weatherer, the first planetnik giant who would become a shepherd for his kin. The planetnik giants were able to put the others to sleep, and only wake them in small groups for short periods of time, to ensure the song continues, even as the builders slumber.
So how does this song of life work?
That is far beyond your understanding. Okay. It is a melody of life, hummed by my kin, to calm the stormy nature of Thea.
Planetic giants so special, where they have been? It's a stupid question. So what went wrong? Why are the giants waking now and destroying the land? And what type of giant are you? You seem much bigger than the ones we've met. I'd like to know this one as well.
Me? I am but an old one. The Oak Father, I was once called, for I chose to serve the Mother Tree, the one that is no more. I have lived with the Elven kin for many millennia, and it was I who gave the younger peoples the power to create the first planet, Nick. My price was my body. As you see, it has become one with the Earth for good. Even when I wake, I will never walk Thea again. But this is good. I fear there is not enough space for me now. And as for my size, well, lucky for you, there are only a few as big as me. And let us hope you will succeed before they wake. but we must return to our business.
So, what went wrong?
I do not know what happened for certain. I only know that the darkness corrupted our sleep. It weaved its way into our dreams and thus infected the hum of life itself. I am older than my kin, so I remember, but the young ones, they wake hungry and confused. Now, not only are all of the giants waking at once, but they do not remember why or what their purpose is. Worse yet, some have been twisted into corrupted fiends, the shadow giants called Mroki, or the unliving corpses. They seem to walk the darkness as if it was a part of them, and their shadow king grows stronger with every passing night.
Okay, enough talk. How do we stop then? Why are the planetary stars as well? What is that? We have seen this. Do we ask that just to... let's do it.
The Planetnik have two skills. One is to collect clouds into their enormous sacks so the giants have more sun. The second is to then change those clouds into sleeping clouds that can put giants into their slumber. While the other giants sleep, the Planetniks sit high up in the clouds and become one with the skies until they are needed again.
Okay, didn't we... What we did all of that, didn't we?
I do not know what happened for certain. Okay. I only know that the dark... Your main objective will be to face the Umbridge Lord before he devours enough souls and before he kills off all the Planetnik giants in order to ascend and thus release all of his darkness upon Thea. You see, it is not that he is evil. That would be too simple. It is just that during his sleep, the darkness weaved its way into his very heart, and now his power of the humming, instead of building the world, seeks to take it apart. You will only have one chance at facing him, so make it count.
All right, so we need to defeat the Umbridge Lord. How do we do that?
There are two ways for you to follow. One, find the Great Weatherer, the first of the Planetnik Giants. He has woken without his memories. Convince him to help you. Remind him of his duties, and you'll have a chance at stopping this. The second way is more bloody. Try to kill as many giants as you can, and then face the Shadow King yourself once you find him, or he finds you. This is not an option I give you lightly. But times are dire for us all.
Pooh. Getting some help would be wise, so where do we find the Planetic Lord? This choice is final, excluded the other option. So we kill lots of giants, but how do we find the Umbridge Lord? This choice is final as well. No, we're getting some help. Fuck that bloodshed.
Alas, I do not know where he dwells. But I have seen signs of his presence throughout the Easterlands. Go seek out signs of his Planetnik kin, or other giants who may know where he is.
Right, so just go out there and search a giant. Shouldn't be too hard. There's the city. We might visit them once. Goblin Village, Giant Cave, though. Wow. Kinda. It's not that evil, actually. We still gonna need to, get our hands on the Mithril. That's still a little bit ahead.
Your scouts report something of interest nearby and mark it on your maps.
Okay.
Your scouts spot a very unusual landmark in the distance, a statue made entirely out of silver. It is likely that some danger may lurk there, as no one has looted it yet, but it is a lot of silver up for the taking.
Okay. Pl- nice to see. We have a new one. A forest elf. Production equipment. Nice stuff, dude. Nice stuff. Might still wanna... it's very light, but it's not the best. 7 damage. We kinda wanna have those guys doing a lot of damage. 8 damage, 7, 5, 13 though. You do that, sir. We might can give you a better aimer. This is 8, 12, 220, can you bear that? Just so. Bow for you. Oh, what do you have actually? 11, okay, no bow for you. But you're gonna need that, sir. We're gonna give him a little bit of stuff. Okay. So all of those guys have? No, they have not. You do that. You do that. You do that. And the rest, you do this, you have, and you have as well. Okay, that's cool. Gathering. Coal is quite enough, actually. Let's let him and... yeah, nobody else deal with the Nimblewood, I guess. Could go and just hire that number a bit up. Okay.
Your scouts spot some giant tracks. They may lead you to the planetnik leader you seek.
Okay.
You see the skies darken and the air getting heavy.
Oh.
The wind picks up and thunder strikes. Strangely, this seems to happen only around you, as you see clear skies up ahead.
This does not seem like a nether storm. Investigate.
Blessed by Perrin's wisdom, you recognize that you must have entered the territory of the wind demons, the Vili. Known for their territorial instincts, the Vili do not like intruders and rarely take time to discuss the matter. Indeed, you now see several winged creatures circling you among the dark clouds.
Is this in the village, actually? We don't know that. If it's the, I would like to know that, actually. View my group. Okay, it's the group, it seems. Yeah, so then, I'm gonna fight him. See if we get a counter offense running. Would be a pity. Be a bigger pity. Counter offense one now. Let's use hers. No, not her. Hers, yeah. Oh, giant crow, but it wasn't that giant, was it? So, how many counter tactics do we have? Do we even have a couple? This is the spear one, counter tactic 5, let's do it. Counter tactics, confuse, counter tactic 3, maybe good for a crow though. Oh, it's their turn. best one would just be Splat 'em, shred 'em.
You defeated the Vili.
Oh, nice.
The storm dies down and the skies clear again.
15, oh wow. That's quite a bit of something loot there. Let them more often visit us, I say. What is this? Can't really know. Auto-resolve. Might be worth to check out that hammer. 7. This is 8. What is this? 16. I would like to check that out on an elf if the other stuff is still good. 15 aimer. 16 aimer. And that hammer. Plus 6 only, okay. But let's check the aimer and let's give this one to an elf. What about the druid? But it is a double wielded axe, so it... We will find another thing. Oh, look at that, yeah, sure. You get that. And you, 14. 16, yeah, and you're ugly as hell. You're lucky little fish, you got better stuff now. 15, that's cool as well. So I guess... Do we gonna give her another spear? I do think we're gonna do that. 7 only, that's fine. Fast reaction, magic, okay. Magic. This is magic. Do that. You have no spot free. You could get some. That's for you, Mrs. Orc. You're welcome. Sure, why not? Sure, why not? What is this actually? Distraction and aimer. No. I will give it to you. One of the various had already distraction though. Do it. And sure, why not? Okay. Okay, that's nice. It's pretty nice, actually.
You come across signs of a giant's crossing, and you also catch rumors of a wildwife sighting not too far away. Perhaps you can find out more information about the planetnik leader you seek if you track her down. The scouts have spotted a group of Yelkalud roaming the hills in the distance. They moved away now, but maybe they hold some clues as to the weatherer giant you seek.
All right. So, place to see this one. Where is that actually? It's not that far away from the place we are. Oh shit, okay. Well, we have to make a better tour. What? Don't do it, don't do it! No! Shit. Let's do a hex. Where did we run to? Can't see shit, and this is something as well. Sneak hex. Oh, gonna get attacked by bats, and they shouldn't be able to do damage. No. Oh, what's that? Monster shell. Let's check it. It's dark, man. Let's go on this place and make camp. Just the mithril, okay. So the best will go and do what they can do. Oh, not even... Oh, one per turn. Okay, five per turn. That's something. We'll stay there for a while, though. We want to have a shit ton of mithril, actually. So, let's go ahead.
The whole land is shaken with the tremors and wild groans of... Despite the daytime, the sky is suddenly overshadowed by a thick, dark mist that slowly engulfs everything in its way. The black mist remains a malicious reminder of the days of darkness and their everlasting hold on Thea. Even the bravest of souls feels a sudden dread as the black cloud slowly seeps into every corner of their surroundings and wraps them up in a suffocating blanket of dark energy. You could swear you see twisted faces and silent screams from within the darkness. You feel a cold chill running down your spine, and dry sweat covers your trembling body. Your very soul is now infected with the cloud. You use magic to create a mystical shield that prevents the mist from touching you. It does not lessen some of the dread you feel from merely looking at the dark matter, madly twisting and turning to try and reach you, but its effects do not reach your soul. The shield will withstand the assault, but if you want, you could push it further and try and fight the mist. The battle will be deadly, and only those who wield magic can face the mist.
Pooh. It's a... Wow. Let's try it. We have four elves, and a couple of our warriors have also plus two magic. The one is way over 10. I kind of think we should try it. Seven hexes, though. Yeah, we can... well, most well, let's... 5, 10... with spear, though. 5. Oh, 24, he's a good one. Actually, I'd like to reshuffle. Maybe we're lucky. 24 is there, okay. So it's our turn. Let's have a look. Who can take a good beating? And is maybe even... Yeah. 16 is more or less the highest we have at the moment. Let's do it. Good luck, my friend. Good luck. Counter offense. 3. Confuse. 3. Counter offense 6, shield alley could be nice as well. Counter tactics 6. Counter offense 7, Pavel, oh man, you were a joker, man. But he has also the alley thing. This is a spear, I don't want to use him now. I say we gonna wait. Do we try the counter tactics? 6, yeah, let's do it. Okay, it's a 4 hex. That changes a bit. Counter offense. You can do at least do a bit of damage. Counter offense 7. Yeah, power. Oh no. We are out of options here. Okay, shield alley, support alley by 3, that would be 8, and he would be done. I say we're gonna do it. Yes. So, next one, you and Pavel will do counter offense. A hex less for now. And we maybe even, This is immediate death to one of those. I guess we're gonna do it. Yeah. Pavel will join the fight next turn. Okay, we are out of options. Zero. That's actually quite nice. He will kill this one. Counter tactics at least for no. Won't do anything. They are 5 and 4. I say we gonna put him closer. I could do Shield Ally as well. That might be something we should consider. Thus, you do you. And we don't even need to shield him. That's kind of nice. Let's put this Forest Elf in. So, zero. It's the opponent turn. Next turn, though. Oh, no, not you. You, yes. And so let's just check. Okay, yes. Yes. 5, not enough, but together they will do 13. They have... Okay, can we support Ellie? Shield Ellie, Shield Ellie. No, we can't support Ellie. And we have no one else who does damage. Wow. That is something. Cool. That's quite something. So you guys need to get closer. You actually can do something. Could do Shield Ally. These guys can't do anything. And none of you would do damage. So that's what we have. Let's try. It will be enough.
To the unknowing eye, the battle lasted but seconds. Yet for those who took part in it, time itself stopped and swallowed them whole. The Black Mist unleashed brutal attacks to try to break free from the mystical powers of your people. Alas, they have proven unbeatable, and so they banished the mist from whence it came, at least for now. The brave souls who fought the mist feel themselves stronger, as they absorb some of the dark magic.
I'm not sure if this is a good thing, but I guess it's fine. Well, we not leave this place. We're not finished yet. 16, we have to make a bit sure that let's activate our bigger resources food-wise. It's not that big anymore, to be honest, but 21 days to go.
The whole land is shaken. Many people get bruised and thrown about, but the tremors event.
So we have the mithril. I guess we have to figure out what we're gonna do with it. I do fear we have to walk this path now because of the moonstone. We have a little bit of moonstone though. Question is, or we want to do damage, or we want to go for the aimer. Might be worth going both ways, actually. Yeah. Yeah, let's have a look. Equipment, production, crafting, heavy ammo. So, we have a bit of this, and we just take a glimpse at what we could do, actually. So, this is 37 and perception 8. This is 33 plus a lot of shielding and perception 5. 30 perception, okay. What about the dragon bone? It's just not enough. What about the enchanted? It's magic, 32 for the magic guys. And yeah, well, it's heavy aimer, but it's quite nice actually. We could do two of those. What about the steel in general? 26 plus magic, also quite nice. That's a pity with the bones actually. So this would be magic, okay. So this is actually what the enchanted stuff is for. This is that. What if this is just normal bones? Yeah. Not really useful. What about this one? 85. But what if 23 plus shielding? Okay. I do think gonna decide for the mithril. Just the amount of armor is just super sick, actually. So we would be able to do two for now, actually. Would be okay. And then we can also switch to that kind of stuff. It's a little bit less, no, and this is also 24 is not small. Even though, I mean, it looks like, you know, but 16 is also not little. Yeah, I say we're gonna do this for now. Or no, we're gonna do this for now. We can do two of those, and that will be just fine. As much as possible, you can do that. This goes one up. So we make two of these, and then we're gonna go ahead with the hunter's bow. By the way, inventory. Just try to recycle as much as possible from those. We get a couple of furs back and then just go ahead doing that. Blunt 9 is not that bad actually. 7 plus will. This is even. It's just dismantle it just for the overview. This is the attractive thing. 4-6 is quite nice stats actually. 4-7 even better. You go away. You go away. 4-5. We will keep the light one. Both kind of fine. 6, nobody wants that. 6. 8, let's get rid of that. 10. Let's keep the mediocre ones a bit around. Let's make him a bit stronger, why not? He will just do more damage. $300 now, $450, okay. He's still a really fragile man. Well, the only man who has ever married in our village. So but that means you can do that. And you're gonna get yourself a decent two-hander, I guess. This one is super light, yeah, that should be fine. An even better aimer. Let's use this one. Okay, same goes for her. It's only 7, 10, 10, and it weighs only that little. I'll go ahead. 48, 4, 4, 6, 8, do that. Okay. A bit more aimer, that's okay. Okay, a bit plus here and there. Yeah, you guys do nothing, that's true. Go ahead. Yeah. Okay, no, it's fine.
There are strange noises in your village at night.
Stay with it.
As you prepare to go to sleep and take one last look out of the windows, you see that the ground seems to be moving. You shout to your fellow villagers and soon realize that your home is swarming with rats.
No shit, we have both hunters in the army, don't we? Yeah, let's do it this way.
You kill many of the rats, but the vermin are slimy and fast. So they manage to eat some of your supplies, and worse yet, some people get sick. Still, you know this could have been much, much worse.
If it doesn't kill you, sickness will eventually wear off. Oh, fuck. Well, at least we have, I will say, actually. $50 already, sweet. But yeah, that's not much actually.
While you scout ahead to see if the road is safe, you notice a bear lying outside its lair. It looks really big. In fact, you have your doubts about it being an ordinary bear and not some kind of giant's pet.
Take a closer look.
The hunters notice that the bear is badly wounded, with a weapon sticking out of its side. Those who know about animals know that wounded beasts can be extremely dangerous and should be approached with great caution.
You know much about animals, but and you know that wounded creatures can grow very attached to their saviors. You can try to help the bear, also tame it. We have quite a bit of animal kins animal thing. Whoa! 10. Shit. Yeah, and we have both hunters in our army as well. And basically all of our... I guess we're gonna try it. Let's try it. Yeah, well, it's here and there quite a bit. Basically everyone can participate somehow. Kinda depends on how the other guys are doing. So let's use her first because she seemed to have the most shielding. Two more first. Let's take the other ones with us. We should have done it actually the other way. We have to look every time first here. Everything else is just plain stupid. So let's go for the damage dealers. Okay. Oh wow. That's not little. 11 and 9. Support alley. Support alley. Counter tactics. Confuse. Shield alley. Shield alley. Counter offense 5. Counter tactics 7. Kinda doubt that we will do something. Shield, confuse 7. That might come in handy. 7 is in range, so to say. She's pretty useless here, yeah. What we could try is... We can at least work with the spears on the second one. Oh shit, I misclicked. Fuck. Just wasted a spear, guys. So, support Ellie by 5, but he can do 7 damage as well by 1. Support Ellie by 2, support Ellie by 4. Still have a spear left though. We can push him up to 14. Let's use those. Do we have another 14? 15? 17? Okay, you will help. I mean, in the end, wait. Well, those three will kill him. This is 3. 3, 11. Don't like to use him actually, but yeah, let's do it this way. We have a first action somewhere. First action 7. It won't help us much though. Boom 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 boom. 11. Let's put her in. Oh, we can't. That's quite a bit, actually. I'm not sure if we can do it. Confuse 7. We could confuse at least 1. This is 12 damage less. Confuse 7. Otherwise you could do at least 7 damage as well. It would be more or less the same as he does. And you get less aimer here, so I guess confuse him. 7 this will kill him, this will kill him. He has a free hit. There's no way we can confuse him, but he won't kill anybody, so that's kind of fine. What we could do is just get a little bit guys in who are able to Well, that's quite a lot. I didn't expect that at all. This game is really nasty, guys. How much do you have there? 10. Do we dare a 7 counter tactic? Yes. Shit, wasted. Okay, we have a shield ally 11. So let's do that. Who's the best here? Well, 7 is the best. Sadly enough. Oh, we can't, okay. So let's hope they don't do much shenanigans. Shield ally. Support or shield? I guess more shielding. In the second turn we will be thankful for that. Then the next best one is she. Oh, it's not our turn. Oh, they just took out... wow, okay. Okay. I see. Shield ally 8 won't help us much. No, we need some... We need to make a sacrifice here. Shit. Shield ally... Well, it's 11. She will survive it, so that's kind of fine. And she does 2 damage. Let's get her in. Nope, it's their turn. Okay, but yeah, and then we have a little bit of damage here. It's not much, though. But we'll see. Oh no, it's fine. Okay. Doesn't look that evil anymore. Down to 5. We have lost 1. Let's get us 4. We can play 3 cards though, so get closer. And get closer. Done. What? Why is that? There was 2 left, wasn't it? Should have killed him. That's shenanigans. Do that. It's their turn. Can counter offense confuse? We don't have a confuse of 8, though we have. Yeah, you will do it, I guess, even though you're a big damage dealer as well. But let's confuse him. Two more. Let's get her closer. And... Marcelka, because she has a decent amount of health. Tactic 7 might worth to use it. Oh shit again. Do we have some spears left here? Yes we do. so... So, I guess support Ellie, and then he is up to 13... 15, shit, it's just not enough. Oh, support Ellie, there's another one. Okay, we can play a couple of cards, that's fine. It's their turn. Okay, we need 16 though. So let's do 16. Okay, then let's shield him as well. One who could survive a strike is Pavel. One strike though, this strike maybe, or he. So we're prepared for both. And then just the small damage dealers will go in. Down. It's not enough here, actually. Didn't expect that. Cool. Yay! Okay.
You help the bear with its wound, and you calm it down enough that it begins to trust you. You give it some honey, and it seems to really like it. Some of you start calling it Wojtek, but the name may not stick. The big bear happily joins your group now.
Yeah, we have a bear. A bear. Sweet. I like it. Oh, there's a... It's a nasty group, actually. So, some magic for you. Can you bear it? No, you can't. But if we give you his thing here, he's a little bit over, but I don't care, to be honest. He's just standing there and doing nothing. Yeah, well, he is overweight, but... Oh, wait. Okay, 500. Oh, okay, sweet. That's... It's actually quite nice. Let's take that away. Oh no, we need the magic here actually. That's fine, but we might have a better shield. I guess he will be glad about 4-6. That was the one with a good stats, wasn't it? Yes, okay, that's fine. Do it this way. So we have to deal with him though. This is the slightest or the lightest thing we have. This is a little bit lighter. Poo. Doesn't look very good, to be honest. 24 has 4 armor. 22 won't change much. 46. 46, 7, you know, 7 is 7, 3, 66, 8 plus dex, so let's do it. Goblin warrior, I can't do shit. How much do we have? 75. So but actually we can basically say 16 per person around that. So we kind of need
your
really
village is
a lot.
Swarmed by the wailing wraiths. They are a force of pure darkness, a menacing wave of tormented souls who seek nothing but the destruction of all life. It seems they have become more frequent of late, more angered and active for some reason.
So we just
those
gave
who know
them
the mystical
the,
ways of magic create a protection spell. It holds much of the evil at bay,
two.
But you still need to fight or lives will be lost.
Let's go ahead, we have the...
your willpower proves stronger than the malicious force of the wailing wraiths. This time, none of your people died. The Age of Darkness left a hefty mark on Thea, as the nights are forever haunted by the Mares, the souls of the living escaped at night to torment their fellow man. These shadowy night creatures bring with them nightmares and despair, weakening anyone unfortunate enough to be touched by their cold breath.
Use magic.
Your wise ones performed a mystical ritual by drawing a protective circle around everyone with a blessed chalk, one that's been dipped in the blood of seven virgins and carried under the armpit of a seventh daughter of a woman with a unibrow. The ritual worked. No Mares touched your people tonight. The next morning, people feel blessed.
Yay!
Slavers are a sadly common sight in Thea these days.
Okay. Where are they? Basically on the way. Oh my god. I guess we shall leave it be then. 80. So there would be kind of six more. Let's go ahead. I have a couple of turns time to catch them, so it's going to be fine. Oh, we are running out of food, actually. Let's fuck these guys up. I would like to go in this direction because the moonstone is really, really useful in terms of stuff. But yeah, to be honest, I'm not sure if we actually have the ability to do so. Let's build a manger. Do we? Yeah, I do think so. I kind of want to try to attract a couple of creatures just to help us out. It's just 9 moonstone, that's not much. Can't do with it, can do nothing with it actually. So crafting, you do this. Just said, what actually? Construction. Oh, we need to, yeah, okay. Village overview, let's get rid of a pasture. So, production, construction, manga. Yeah, we have still a shitload of this. How much do we have of that? Not enough. 25, oh no, we don't have enough of that. What a pity, actually. Enough. Let's see what it does. Attract beast, +3 animal kinship. +1 animal kinship and +1 attract beast. More or less this, no effect. Oh man, if we could do this, but +3 is already quite nice actually. 25 attract beasts, +4 attract beasts, then we'll do something. Are we finished with our bow wishes? Let's confirm that and check it actually. We have quite a bit laying around, and are we equipped? Not really, not all of us at least. he can't. Yeah, he's a medic, it's fine. So we would need a couple of, but... this is 30 after that, so I guess it's gonna be fine. You two going in. Yeah, let's do it. Track beast 3 will maybe lure a beast to us. I'm a little bit scared about these guys.
You approach the slavers and see they are a mixed group of different peoples, including orcs, humans, goblins, and even dwarves. They
attack. I'm not here to talk. There's no place for slavery. Tactic, counter offense would be really sad if we get a wolf. Shit. Counter tactic 4, the bear. Yeah, cool. Counter offense, counter tactic. I'm not sure. Another counter tactic 4. We can fuse basically everyone, but.
You killed all the slavers. You gather up those who can still walk and make a... You come across a hidden stash, and it looks like whatever is inside may... At the last moment, you realize the stash is protected by a hex. Remember, without magic users, the fight will likely be impossible.
Break it.
You broke the hex. Whatever magic trick protected the stash...
Okay. We have a lot of space actually. Let's try to go for this one.
Another night falls over Thea, and restless souls of the damned seek out the living in envy and anger. You can almost feel the approaching wave of these infernal wraiths seeking to burden your souls. But this night, a welcomed guest is seen in the shadows, a Lapiduk, the spirit catcher. This bizarre looking creature, resembling an overgrown toad with long claws, yellow warts, and a row of razor-sharp teeth, is actually a humble servant of Velez. Okay. In the old days, tasked with the hunting of wayward souls and misbehaved wraiths, but now, hopelessly overfed, and ever busy with his task of devouring evil spirits.
Okay.
Thanks to the Lapiduk, your people sleep well this night, and many feel the magical touch of Velez upon them.
Sweet. Okay, guys, we're gonna stop here, and I say, wherever you are, have a nice one. I see you at the next episode. Goodbye.